To me, if you know, we were talking a minute ago about tracing this causal chain backwards forever. What created the universe? Well, God. Well, what created God? Some other God. And you know, eventually you have to supposedly get to something that always existed. And so the religionists, particularly Christians and modern religions, say that God is the thing that always existed. And my answer, which is not unique to me, I mean this is common among most atheists. No, my answer is, there's no reason to go back one step to the God. We're already justified in accepting that the universe always existed in some form. There's no reason to posit something else beyond it that always existed.
As far as we know, matter and energy can't be created or destroyed, so for all intents and purposes, as far as we're concerned, it's eternal. Now, that may not be true, but it's like what Hawking... and say he produced it, just matter in itself is destructible and potentially eternal, so, you know, exist and we can't stop it, and that's what matter does. So matter began.
Well, I'm a little confused. And what is the Big Bang Theory? Because from what I understand, the Big Bang Theory was when everything started to become. That's what
not to become
molecules and so forth and so on.
No.
Big Bang.
That's what you're misunderstanding the theory.
Am I really okay?
Yeah.
Basically, the Big Bang traces it back to the point where everything that exists, everything in our universe, was compacted into one tiny singularity.
Right.
Right, 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 right.
Now, I don't want to make the claim that the singularity was some real tangible thing there, but what we're talking about with the Big Bang is the expansion of everything from the singularity outwards, and it proceeds out at a rate that is measurable, and the force of the explosion can be measured in the cosmic background radiation. I mean, all of this stuff is scientifically confirmable. So,
right, and it's still expanding, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Although it may slow down and contract.
That's all I'm saying to you, man. That's all I'm asking.
What's that?
What started that expansion? I'm asking.
Nobody knows.
Yeah, Hawking says it's untraceable at this point.
Nobody knows.
All right.
We have possible theories, but unfortunately, because of the nature of reality, we can't get back beyond the Planck time to the point, to the time of the event. We can't cross the event horizon.
Right.
But there are some good theories, and there are ideas. And the bigger thing is that as long as... Even if we never had a good theory, even if everything we found just failed and never gave us an answer, that doesn't mean that God did it ever becomes viable, because that is a hypothesis on its own that requires evidentiary support.
Right. It needs to be supported. It can't just be to make a claim and then not to support that claim, or to support it simply by saying this other claim is false.
I understand. So you guys are better off in your mind, have more teeth in your mind by just simply saying, okay, you know what? This is just simply unknowable.
Correct.
Well, I wouldn't say unknowable.
Whereas that answer right there is going to have my people calling day in and day out.
Yeah, it's unknown now. I don't know that it's necessarily unknowable. It may be that we come up with an answer. The thing, and I don't know if this will help or make it more difficult, but one thing is to consider the answer. How does saying God created the universe fundamentally any different from saying magical, transcendent, universe-building pixies created the universe?
Really, not a whole lot of difference. Because either one of them can be photographed, pictured, or proven.
Correct.
So, so I can see your point on that. But I mean, I've got to have people. I guess people in general, because if you look at the atheists, or if you look at the Christians, or should I say, people who believe in God, you know, you guys are a minority.
Oh yeah, we
sure.
Know that.
Okay, cool. So you do know that.
Yeah.
So I think what it is most human nature people, we have to have some type of answer. We're just not gonna go with this is unknowable.
Don't
I won't take up too much of your time, man. I mean, I'm gonna you know, go right, here. Okay. But
well, we appreciate the call,
sure
Tracy.
Like
we'll go ahead.
I like how honest you are about how you feel and stuff.
Thank you.
We appreciate the call.
It was just a story that related. It was a Buddhist story about a person that comes to Buddha and he's complaining. I think I might have said it before on the show, so I don't want to spend too much time, but one of his followers comes and complains that I've come to follow you because people told me that you were this wise master, and ever since I've been here now, it's been 5 years, and you have never once explained, like, universal origins or, and all these, it's these religious, heavy religious questions about you haven't, you know, where did the universe come from? Why are people intelligent? Why, you know, all these things that you've not given me an answer to. And Buddha says to him, if you were shot with an arrow, would you let me remove the arrow, or would you tell me I can't take the arrow out until I find out who shot you? And the point being, he's like, I can help you deal with your emotions and deal with your emotional pain, but there, if I don't know, do you have to know the answer to this in order to basically cope with your life?
Right.
And so Buddha's answer was, these questions don't really matter in the grand scheme of living your life and doing what you need to do and getting by and, you know, having emotional control, being fulfilled, being happy does not require that you know who shot you. Certain questions don't require an answer for you to have a happy life, and one of them is, where did the universe come from?
Yeah. Towards the end, he made this comment that, you know, we recognize that we're a minority, and he's like, well, we're human beings, man, we want to answer this question, and we're going to believe in something like this. And I'd say, no. That's the whole point. It doesn't matter that we're a minority. We don't even need to bring numbers into it. The point I'm making is that you don't have to, whether it's the majority doing it, whether it's out of comfort, adopt this standard method of, I'm so uncomfortable with not knowing that I'm going to accept some answer even though there's no good reason to accept it. That's not the way to go about things. There is a better way. When people say, well, all you do is rail against religion, tell us what's so good about atheism. Well, first of all, as I mention every time, it's not a dogma, it's not a religion, it's not a philosophy, it's not a way of life, it's a response to theism. But what I'm talking about with the scientific method, with the naturalistic approach, the philosophical naturalism used as an approach to discovering reality, that's what we're talking about in this case. And that is an incredibly beautiful thing because it is the one and only consistently reliable, independently verifiable method that we have for understanding reality. It's not knowledge that's power, it's understanding. You can know facts and not how to use them. Understanding reality is the best tool that you have. And the best way to hone that tool is to use logic, reason, and evidence. Put that together, come up with a method that allows you, and you don't have to invent this yourself, it's not particularly hard. It involves critical thinking, skepticism, analysis. How reliable are your sources? Asking yourself those questions allows you to fine-tune and hone your mind so that you can believe as many true things and as few false things as possible. That's the key. That's the key to understanding. If there's a question that we don't have an answer to, boy, that's frustrating. It's annoying. I'd love to know how it all started. I'd love to know without any doubt how it all started. I'd like to know every aspect of every element from history that's ever happened to anybody, because that would give me the kind of understanding that I could really appreciate. But we can't. I can't know what was going through Napoleon's mind. I can't know. I can't know if Jesus Christ ever existed, and if he did, who he was, what he was, what he said, what he did. All I can do is take the best evidence available and piece together and come up with some kind of belief, some position to some degree of certainty. And I need to weigh that against the effects of holding those beliefs. Once you do that, you build a model of reality that is useful, accurate, and reliable. That's the key. You don't have to just, oh, I can't come up with anything better, so God did it. You know, when did this become justifiable so that, yes, we're a minority, and the majority of people do this? So when in our evolution did it become acceptable, and not just acceptable, lauded for people to accept unreal propositions as if they were real, in order to alleviate the discomfort of saying, I don't know. I can't justify it.